life and work for Poland and Norway, a great patriot and engineer. Aleksander, Fortunat, Józef, Roch, Waligórski.
He was born on the 26th of February 1802 in Drugni, Poland. He gets a general and military education in the cadet training corps in Kalisz, Poland. From 1820 he starts attending the military application school in Warsaw. In 1826 he becomes a lecturer in it, as well as in the artillery school where he teaches maths, geometry and mechanics. On the 12th of August 1828 Waligórski is awarded with the Order of Saint Stanislaus for pedagogical merit.
He involves in a conspiracy which results in the November uprising in Poland between 1830 and 1831, during which he serves as an artilleryman. Waligórski receives the Order of Virtuti Militari for his service twice. After the uprising falls, he leaves Poland for France, where he studies in French artillery school in Metz. In 1836, he comes to Norway and works as the director of the Harbors and Canals Maintenance Department.
Aleksander spent 17 years in Norway straightening the rivers and constructing canals. Moreover, he is one of those who plan a railway line and manages building the first part of it. Waligórski and Harald Wergeland published the first complete road map of Norway. While there, he commits himself to social activity. In appreciation for his works and effort for the country, in 1849, Aleksander Waligórski is admitted to the Royal Norwegian Society of Science and Letters in Trondheim as a member of the Science Division. From 1848, for over a year, he is Adam Czartoryski's agent in Scandinavia.
He takes the part in the January uprising against the Russian Empire in 1863. He is the main quartermaster and commander of the military forces in the Lubelski region. At the time, he has his son Władysław with him, and together they fight for regaining independence on Poland. Władysław, who was born in Norway in 1847 and later attended school in Batignolles in France, dies during the Battle of Kobylanka of the 6th of May 1863 at the age of 17.
After the defeat of the uprising, he returns to France. Between 1865-68, he is the president of Polish Military Association. He also fights in the Franco-Prussian War as commons a soldier. He dies on the 19th of July 1873 in the house of Saint Casimir in Paris, when he spends his final days of his life. He buried at the cemetery in Paris. In the 19th century, Waligórski was recognized as the best engineer in Norway, and the Norwegian parliament regarded seeing him leave his post there in order to continue the battle for Polish freedom.
Aleksander Waligórski died 143 years ago in Paris, but no grave with his name on it exists there. He did so much for Norway that he still remains vivid in the memory of the Norwegians. Consequently, under the patronage of Norwegian ambassador, Waligórski's symbolic tomb was founded and unveiled at the Paris Cemetery in 2016. On the 17th of May 2017, the John Paul II Private Elementary School in Drugnia organized the Day of Norway, during which General Aleksander Waligórski was commemorated once more.